गुड मॉर्निंग डियर फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर विक्रांत सुधाकर पालेकर। आई एम वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन गोखले एजुकेशन सोसाइटीज आर्ट्स कॉमर्स एंड साइंस कॉलेज जवाहर पालेकर। इन द सीरीज ऑफ हेट्रोसाइक्लिक केमिस्ट्री वी आर डूइंग दिस पार्ट 4 ऑन द रिएक्शंस ऑफ क्विनोलिन। इन द अर्लियर पार्ट वी हैव सीन द रिएक्टिविटी ऑफ पिरिडिन एनऑक्साइड क्विनोलिन एंड आइसोक्विनोलिन, इट्स प्रिपरेशन। Then we have seen in the last video the reactions given by pyridine and oxide, and in this particular session we are going to see the reactions given by quinoline. As we know that aromatic compounds favor aromatic electrophilic substitution reactions, as if we see the basic substitution reactions where we know that weak electrophile is being replaced by strong electrophile. If we see the examples of electrophilic substitution reactions, then nitration reaction, halogenation reactions, sulfonation reactions, alkylation reactions, these are the basic examples of electrophilic substitution reaction. If we see in case of the nitration reactions, where the hydrogen is being substituted by nitro group by using nitrating mixture, where NO2 is being act as a electrophile. In case of halogenation reaction, the hydrogen being substituted by halogen by using ion as a catalyst. So this is a simple reactions where we can say the electrophilic substitution reaction takes place in aromatic system. As in case of the quinoline, we have seen its reactivity. As we know that the pyridine ring is quite deactivated, and in case of the electrophilic substitution reaction, the position number 5 and position number 8 is more favored for electrophilic substitution reactions, as due to the incoming electrophile, whatever the charge space is being formed, they are quite stabilized. That's why the position number 5 and position number 8 is quite favored. While in case of the nucleophilic substitution reactions, as we know that pyridine ring is more pi electron deficient, so that's why the incoming nucleophile will favor the position number 2 and 4. So we have to remember that the nucleophilic substitution reactions favored or takes place at 2 and 4 positions, as these positions are more electron deficient. So this is we have to remember in case of the quinoline. As these are the some canonical structures, as we know that whenever electrophilic substitution takes place at 5 and 8 positions, these structures are quite stable, because whenever the electrophile get added to at 5 and 8 positions, whatever the charge space is formed, that is carbocation is being formed, that is being stabilized inside the benzene ring, and aromaticity of the pyridine ring is not disturbed. In the series of reactions, we are going to see the first reactions given by the quinoline is halogenation reaction. The more specifically we see bromination reaction. Look at the reactions. Quinoline molecule, when reacted with bromine in presence of acidic condition, the bromine is being introduced at 5 position and 8 positions. So for bromination reactions, you will get the mixture of two products. One is 5-bromoquinoline and another is 8-bromoquinoline. So these are the two products which are being formed in case of the bromination in acidic conditions. So remember this particular reaction for halogenation. In the subsequently, even if you carry out another halogenation reaction like chlorination or iodination, you will get the electrophilic substitution reaction at position number 5 and 8. Then next reaction, nitration reaction. As we know that for nitration reactions, we need a nitrating mixture, that is HNO3 and H2SO4, and it is generally being carried out at 0 degrees Celsius. So when quinoline reacted with the nitrating mixture, you will get the nitration at position number 5 and position number 8 in equal proportion. So as a result of that nitration, the quinoline results in the mixture of 5-nitroquinoline and 8-nitroquinoline in equal proportion, or you will get somewhat different proportion, but definitely you will get the mixture. So remember, in case of nitration also, you will get the electrophilic substitution reactions at position number 5 and position number 8. Then we are going to see the amination reactions. As we know that amination reaction is the nucleophilic electrophilic substitution, nucleophilic substitution reactions. So amination reaction is well known as a Chichibabin reaction. Remember this particular amination reaction as a Chichibabin reaction. So there are two conditions which favor two different products. We will see first when quinoline is reacted with the sodamide and ammonia in the presence of potassium permanganate at minus 66 degrees Celsius. So at minus 66 degrees Celsius, you will get amination specifically at two positions, and you will get the product 2-aminoquinoline. So 2-aminoquinoline is obtained as a product when you carry out reaction at minus 66 degrees Celsius. As we know that the reactions are temperature dependent. So same reaction, if you carried out at minus 40 degrees Celsius in presence of sodamide, ammonia and potassium permanganate, you will get the amination at position number 4. So in this case, if you maintain the temperature, you will not get the mixture of two products. So this is a temperature dependent reaction. So remember, temperature plays a very important role. So you have to remember that in case of the quinoline, the amination, that is nucleophilic substitution reaction, takes place at 2 and 4 position by using sodamide. Then next reaction with butyl lithium. As we know that butyl lithium is very strong base. So quinoline, when reacted with the butyl lithium in anhydrous condition, so what happens, this butyl lithium will get added across this position number 1 and 2. So lithium to nitrogen and butyl group at second positions. So in the next step, water is being added. So what will happen, this particular bond undergo breakdown. So you will get butyl group at two positions. Okay, in the next step, what will happen, the nitrobenzene, and at higher temperature you will get butyl group is being introduced inside two positions, second positions. Okay, so as a result of that, you will get the product 2-butyl quinoline. So this particular reaction, if you see, this is a simple alkylation reaction. If you see this particular reaction, starting compound and this particular product, so you will get, you will see that a simple butyl group is being introduced at second position. So this is an alkylation reaction. As we know that alkylation reaction is the electrophilic substitution reaction. So if you carry out simple alkylation reaction like Friedel-Crafts reaction, you will get the alkylation at 5 and 8 position. But by using butyl lithium, we can effectively carry out this particular reaction, and butyl group is being introduced at second positions. So this particular reaction is quite important when you want specifically the alkyl group is being introduced inside the pyridine ring. Okay, so this particular reaction we need to remember by using butyl lithium. Then after the electrophilic and nucleophilic reactions, this quinoline is also susceptible for different reducing reagents. We will see one by one. first hydrogen and platinum is used as a reducing reagent. So what happens? Quinoline in presence of H2 and PT, it undergo reduction in the pendant ring. So what happens? The hydrogen is being added inside the pendant ring and you will get 1, 2, 3, 4 tetrahydroquinoline. Okay, so in case of the reducing reagent, what we can say, when the hydrogen is being added, 4 hydrogen is being added at position number 1, 2, 3 and 4. So you will get 1, 2, 3, 4 tetrahydroquinoline in presence of H2PT. So we can say the pyridine ring is being get reduced by using H2PT. Subsequently, if you used another reducing reagent, which is at acidic condition, means H2PT at by using 12 normal HCl, the reduction will take place in the benzene ring. So whole benzene ring get reduced. As we know that the quinoline is a fused system of benzene ring and pyridine ring. So at very acidic conditions, what will happen? The reduction will take place at 5, 6, 7 and 8 position. So as a result of that, you will get the product 5, 6, 7, 8 tetrahydroquinoline. The 4 hydrogens in being added at 5, 6, 7 and 8 position. So that's why you can say, we can generally say that by using a specific reagent, the pyridine ring and carbocyclic ring also can be selectively reduced. Then next reducing reagent is lithium in presence of liquid ammonia. So quinoline, when reacted with lithium and liquid ammonia, you will get selective reduction at 1,4 position. So what will happen? 1,4 dihydroquinoline is obtained as a product. Remember this particular reactions in presence of lithium in liquid ammonia. 1,4 dihydroquinoline is obtained as a product. While by using another very strong reducing reagent, that is lithium aluminum hydride, so you will get selective reduction at 1 and 2 positions. So hydrogen is being specifically added at 1 and 2 position in the pyridine ring, and as a result of that, you will get 1,2 dihydroquinoline. So two hydrogens being added at 1 and 2 positions in the pyridine ring, so you will get the 1,2 dihydroquinoline as a product by selective reduction of quinoline by using lithium aluminum hydride. Remember this particular reaction, by using different reducing reagent we can get different products. Now we will see the oxidizing reactions given by the quinoline. When we react quinoline with alkaline K-monophore, the benzene ring gets opens up, and you will get that benzene ring get opens up and there is a breakdown occur at this position and at this position. As a result of that, you will get two carboxylic group added. So as a result of that alkaline K-monophore reaction of quinoline, you will get pyridine 2,3 dicarboxylic acid as a product. If you carry out same reaction of quinoline by using ozone, this particular reaction is called as a ozonolysis reaction. By carrying out ozonolysis reaction, you will get dicarboxylaldehyde. So again, the benzene ring gets open up at 5 position and 6 position and 7 position and 8 position. So as a result of that, you will get CHO means dialdehyde and glyoxal as a byproduct. In the above also you will get one of the byproduct. So remember that whenever the ozonolysis reaction is carried out for quinoline, you will get pyridine 2,3 dicarboxylaldehyde. So this is a oxidizing reagent. We specifically used in the presence of oxidizing reagent, the benzene ring opens. Okay, and you will get the different oxidizing product by using different reagent. In the presence of alkaline KMnO4, you will get carboxylic acid. By using ozonolysis, you will get dialdehyde, or we can say dicarboxylaldehyde. Then next reaction is with peracid. When quinoline is reacted with the peracid or with H2O2, the oxidation reactions will take place at nitrogen, and you will get the product as quinoline N-oxide. So simple oxidation reaction, like in case of the pyridine, when reacted with the H2O2, we get pyridine N-oxide. In the similar way, whenever the quinoline is reacted with the peracid, we will get product as a quinoline N-oxide, which is again a zwitterionic species. So remember this particular reaction as a preparation of quinoline N-oxide from quinoline by using peracids. So in this particular session, we have seen different reactions like halogenation reaction, that is bromination, which takes place at 5 and 8 position, nitration, which takes place at again 5 and 8 positions, amination reaction, that is Chichibabin reactions, which can be selectively used at different temperatures to get 2 amino quinolines and 4 amino quinolines. And we have seen a different oxidizing reagent and reducing reagent, which can be selectively used to oxidize quinoline moiety and also to reduce this particular quinoline molecule by carrying out different reactions. So remember, these are the reactions which are being favored by quinoline. These particular reactions are important as there are questions on the this particular topics where they are asked what happens when this quinoline molecule reacted with the different reaction. So go through this particular video, definitely you will understand the reactions given by the quinolines. With this particular session, we will stop here. Thank you.